It's Marga Day, one of many. And I'm at the Pangda O Pagoda Market. I think I got that right. But it's a huge market. I've been here over an hour and I just covered about 10% of it. So I'm gonna walk and show you what I find interesting here. First of all, I always find these kitchens, these restaurants, they are very cool. Everything, there's so much smoke, there's so much atmosphere there. And the thing is, well, when is it safe? I just ate there and it's completely safe. When is it safe? Well, yeah, you just have to make a judgment call or ask someone you trust. If you have a guide or something like that, he will be able to help you with that. And so here's another restaurant. This is a little bit more fancy, you know, looks kind of Japanese. Everybody's sitting on the floor and yeah, you have to take off your shoes before you go in. And here's another restaurant. And all this, it looks clean, it looks safe. If you saw my video from Yangon, the big market there, the wholesale market, I would not eat there. Every market has a blacksmith, either to sell his knives or to sharpen stuff for farmers and people who need sharp stuff, obviously. But here's the thing, if you look at these guys, these blacksmiths, you know, it is about the manliest job you can have, you know. They are, you know, heating iron steel onto fire, then they're banging it, stuff, you know, it's they're all strong and sweaty. That kind of sounded a little gay, but you know what I mean. And another very manly job would be a lumberjack. You know, these two jobs, blacksmith and a lumberjack, it ranks really high in the manliest job around. And here, this guy is just, it looks like he had one animal and he is here to sell his animal, I guess. I don't know. But let's move on. Here is the fruit market and stuff like this. And the thing is with these places here, these are souvenirs, look at that. Souvenir stuff. When you walk through these parts of these markets, there is a little bit of people trying to sell you stuff, but for example, when you walk through the meat market, nobody bothers you. They know a tourist is not going to buy meat. Well, it's highly unlikely. And more fruit and some other stuff, I don't know what is. Thank you. And here are the clothes. They have all the brands, Nike, Supreme, Dolce & Gabbana, they have all that stuff, but I'm thinking not authentic. But this place here, Fish market. A lot of fish. This is fish. They fish here in Lake Inle, and they always bring it. They always bring it alive because they get no good price for it if it's dead. They fish it, and they have a special basket to get it. I will show you that in another video, how they actually do that, how they catch them alive. But then they just have water in the boat, they put the fish in the boat and bring them straight to the market alive. And you know, and then they're just covered with flies. And hello, how are you? Good? Happy people. But the thing is, here with this fish market, it's kind of located here on the edge of the dump. You know, it just doesn't look clean. Well, it doesn't look clean. It is not clean, but I guess you have to throw your shit somewhere, and this is as good a place as any, I guess. In trips like that, markets are a huge part of what we do, what we should. Why? Just look at it. There's so many, fix this a little bit. So many people, like in this area, there's so many ethnic groups. So people have their own identity with clothing they're selling. And it's a happening place. People are here meeting other people, making money, doing business, they're happy. It's a happy place. So it is one of the best place to, if you're interested in shooting people or photographing people, so I sound not so lethal, markets are a great way. And also, photography is expected somewhat. Nobody's going to mind. Hi girls, what are you selling? So this is like a little pharmacy. Yeah, there we go. So I wonder what they have. Let's see. Do you have something like painkillers or something strong? Morphine? You have morphine? No morphine. no morphine. Viagra? You have Viagra? Viagra? No, thanks. No morphine. Yeah. Traditional medicine. Okay, yeah, that's a whole different thing. Okay. So, thank you. No morphine, no Viagra. I'm gonna take my business elsewhere. Let me see. Here are knives. And I showed you the blacksmith before. The woman who was selling for him, she was trying to sell me knives. She brought all kind of knives. And these, they were nice. And they didn't cost much money. But I was trying to tell her, I'm a photographer. I don't need a fucking knife. You know, lens, you have something, you have lenses. But she didn't really understand. And also, what I would like, I see some swords, huge swords. You know, they have a lot of traditional martial arts. And swords are part of it, fighting sword. And I would really like that. And some of those knives, they are very cool, just for ornament. I'm not gonna go kill anybody. But, I'm not gonna put that just in my suitcase or Yeah, when this tour is over, I just want to go home. I don't want to go to prison. So I'm afraid the airport police would not be happy if I would bring a collection of knives and swords with me. I don't think so. I could be wrong. So I decided to get a haircut. I don't really need it, but I never tried this setting, so let's do this. The guy doesn't understand me, but make me beautiful. Yeah. He understands that. He understands beauty. I mean, he must understand beauty. He's a hairdresser. There we go. So I'm thinking, the thing is with haircuts in Iceland. In Iceland, I pay like $60 for a simple haircut. And I'm guessing it's a little cheaper here.
It's 1,000.
That's about a dollar. Not even a dollar. It's less than a dollar. So I'm saying, you know, if I lived in a place like this, I would get a fucking haircut every day. So I could get 60 haircuts for one haircut in Iceland. And I'm guessing that these guys, they do as good job as their Icelandic colleagues. I could be wrong. We'll see after he's done. Myanmar. Very often when I buy stuff from these markets, I often buy some traditional clothes or souvenirs or t-shirts or, you know, what, sometimes fruits and stuff. There is always room for bargaining. Always room for some bargaining. But here's the thing. Usually the asking price is low if we compare it to anything we know in the West. So very often, it depends on who is selling, how the vendor is looking. You know, on these kind of markets, some bargaining is expected. You know, they will try 50% more, and you will just say half of the price, and then they go up, and then you walk away, and then they follow you and say okay. But sometimes if I see like a vendor just on the street who's alone, you know, it looks like a thing that they are doing for survival. It's not exactly a business. I just pay the asking price. It's not gonna bankrupt me, and it's gonna make someone's life, someone's day a little easier. These people do not have much, and they're not asking for much. either. So normally I just do that. I just pay the asking price, except for the souvenir stuff. You know, if you're buying like these statues or whatever, these souvenirs, especially on these locations where a lot of tourists are expected, then I try to bargain a little bit. Stuff like this, for example. Lava. What is this? It's Buddha. Shan language. So Shan is one of the tribe here?
This is Buddha story.
Okay.
The Buddha story.
Mm-hmm.
And this is Shan people, Shan state, Shan yeah. people, Shan yeah. language.
Yeah.
And Shan.
And Shan is yeah. writing.
And writing.
Yeah.
And Buddha
story. Yeah, this is nice. How much is this?
The Chao Dola.
How much in dollars?
Dollar.
See what he asks for.
Dollar and $35.
$35, okay.
Discount, you pay how much? Good morning. Five customers this morning.
Yeah.
Lucky money.
Oh, good.
Lava, lucky money.
No, it's good. I'll be back.
You pay yeah. how much?
I'm gonna think about it. I'm gonna walk around and I'll be back if I want it.
First money, first customer, discount.
Yeah.
Discount, you pay how much? Lucky money, first customer.
First customer.
First customer.
No, not now. Later. Thank you.
First customer, lucky money.
I know.
Lucky money, first customer, yeah. discount.
Yeah, later.
Discount, you pay how much? Discount.
Later. Thank you.
Discount, hello.
Yeah, no discount.
Lucky money.
Thank you.
So
sometimes, if you're early, like he was saying, first customer, lucky money. Sometimes if you're early, the first sale is lucky money. I think it was something like that. So it's like the first sale is really important to them. Every sale is important, but you know, you see, it's very difficult. Once you show interest in this stuff, it's very difficult to walk away, because you feel kind of guilty. You made him show this, and I never intended to buy. Hi. What? What do you got? Okay, this is a bottles opener.
Yeah, good.
For beer. Oh, I don't drink beer.
Money lucky.
Again, money lucky. You know, sale this morning. Thank you. Everybody got lucky money. Well, I guess I got the lucky money for them, but you know. So now it's not that early anymore, and tourists have started to. It's nice to be ahead of the tourists. It is because the thing is with tourists, they have their cameras. You know, I know everything about that. They have the cameras. They're shoving it in people's faces, and first thing in the morning when it's early, people are not. They're not tired of it yet. But later in the day, there are more and more tourists. Everybody's shooting people, and it gets boring for them, I guess. I find it easier to walk around and talk like this with the camera and pointing the camera at people. They always respond nicely because I'm making a video. For some reason, that's more fun for them. But because it's more interaction, you know. I'm trying to get interaction. I'm trying to make some conversations. As with the camera, yes, of course there's interaction. I always try to get you know, approval or make some contact to get nicer photos. But this is different. This is kind of easier. If you're comfortable, at least, with talking like this in public, it's not particularly easy for me. At first, I was really bad at it. I guess I still am. But I think it's getting a little better. At least I don't feel like I'm out of breath all the time when I'm doing this. No, thank you.
What? This is Sanna.
Sword. Yeah, there we go. Here we are. They're trying to sell me knives again.
Yeah.
Ooh. This looks sharp.
Yeah.
Dangerous. Yeah. But the thing is, dude, if I try to take this home at the airport, the police will... Oh, yeah. Thank you. No, thank you. Yeah. Lucky money. But this is the entrance at the market. Well, one of many. And at the entrances, you will only see tourist stuff. Yeah, there's that. Because they try to grab them as soon as they get in. So souvenirs at the entrance. Hello. And the thing is also with these markets that if you see something on one market, you try to bargain and he says no and he doesn't follow you, don't panic. Just go to another market, they all have the same stuff. But now it's time to move on from this market. And yeah, I guess this is long enough for one video anyway. So thank you for watching this market day video. See you later. Goodbye.
Oh, I get blue in the morning. I get blue in the evening too. I get blue in the morning time. I get blue in the evening too. If the evening come around too long, Lord have mercy, I get blue in the afternoon. Listening to the birds outside my window, I say, Lord, put a heart song on me, yeah. Listening to put a heart song on me. They're waking up in the morning, they ain't blue, still they can't sing.